Well, money's getting cheaper, prices getting steeper. Found myself a woman, but I just couldn't keep her. Times get tougher than tough. Things getting rougher than rough. Well, I make a lot of money, I just keep spending the stuff. Well, pork chops on the market, asked butcher for a pound. Couldn't buy a pork chop when I laid my money down. Times get tougher than tough. Things getting rougher than rough. Well, I make a lot of money, I just keep spending the stuff. Telling folks to cut out on that meat. Why don't they cut the price and let the people eat? Times get tougher than tough. Things getting rougher than rough. Well, I make a lot of money, I just keep spending the stuff. What I can't afford to live, I guess I'll have to try. Undertaker's got a union and it costs two mercy to die. Times getting tougher than tough. Things getting rougher than rough. Well, I make a lot of money, I just keep spending the stuff.
This is Jazz Casual. I'm Ralph Gleason, and you've been listening to Jimmy Witherspoon sing the blues, accompanied by Ben Webster on tenor sax, Vince Guaraldi on piano, Monty Budwig on bass, and Colin Bailey on drums. Spoon.
Hi, Ralph.
How are you? That was lovely.
Thank you.
Where do the blues come from?
Well, Ralph, that's another hard question. Only thing I can say, I started singing in church, in a little church in Arkansas. And later in Calcutta, India, I was in the Merchant Marine and I heard the blues and I started singing with Teddy Weatherford.
Mm-hmm. That was the pianist that was playing.
That's right.
Does the blues have a relationship to church music, Spoon?
Yes, very much so. The music is more or less the same.
Feeling?
Lyrics, the feeling is the same. Lyrics have changed. Some of it, the blues are happy, some sad. And, well, it's a little mixed up thing, but it's...
What do the blues express to you when you sing them?
Depends on what has happened to me the night before or the week before.
Uh-huh. You put this into the song?
That's right.
You change the lyrics from time to time?
I don't change the lyrics, but I know so many lyrics, I can adjust myself, you know.
And bring out the things that you feel at that
that
moment?
That's right.
Do you ever sing as blues songs? Do you ever sing songs that have been church songs?
No, I did a religious album once on the hi-fi jazz. And it was a little spiritual thing, but it wasn't really what I'd sing in church.
Mm-hmm. Did you hear blues when you were a youngster?
Yes, I did.
What kind of blues?
I heard the blues, like Muddy Waters and even Memphis Slim, you know, and Peter Wheatstraw and all that bunch, you know. They used to make records. And
did you get to know these people when you began?
No, I didn't. Never did.
Did you get to know other blues singers when you started singing?
Yes, I did.
Do you learn from one another?
I listen to all of them and get a little from each one and put my little bit in it.
Do you teach one another songs, for instance?
No, I never have.
You never?
I never have, because they have usually steal each other's lyrics, you know, get them on records. Because I think every blues has been sung by some other blues singer, really.
Back through the years.
That's right.
I noticed that you and Ben Webster worked together particularly well on blues songs, in which Ben almost seems like another voice with you. Do you feel it this way when you...
Well, ever since that Monterey Jazz Festival in '59, it's been a close relation with Ben and myself. And it's very fortunate to have a great saxophone like him, you know, working with me.
Does it seem to you that when he's playing and he's answering you in a way, that it's another voice singing?
Very similar.
Does he give you ideas for feelings to get into your music?
I've learned a lot from Ben, believe it or not, not only in the singing, but in stage appearance and everything else. He's the boss of it.
Have there been many other instrumentalists that have affected your blues singing?
Jay McShann.
Jay McShann was the band that you were.
That's right. That was the first band I sang with, and for the blues, mm-hmm. he did more to influence me, and then Joe Turner, and Big Jim Russian, Ray Charles, B.B. King. Yeah. I got quite a few.
Have you had your own band and sang with that too?
Yes, I did for about 3 years.
Is it helpful for you to have a unit, or can you work just as easily singing the blues as solo?
It's better singing than solo.
Oh, it is?
Yes, it is.
How?
Well, you don't have to worry about you're going to make the gig the next day, whether the 7 or 8 men, you know you can make it. And it's a worry, it's a mental strain on you.
Have you ever written a blues about that?
No, I haven't. One of these days I will. Believe me, I can.
To you then, when you're singing a blues is an expression of your feelings and what's happened to you?
Over the years,
Over the years.
That's right.
Have you ever had a specific thing happen at one moment in your life that you've immediately wanted to put into a song?
Yes, that happened on a tune I call The Sun Should Be Shining, But the Rain Keeps Falling Down. I was in New York, Flanders Hotel, and I was getting ready to go back to Los Angeles for the first time in about 4 years. Yeah. And I wrote a song in the Flanders Hotel. It rained that entire weekend. Yeah. And I wrote, The Sun Should Be Shining, But the Rain Keep Falling Down.
Well, Spoon, I think it would be good now for our audience if you could sing us something that featured your vocals and Ben's playing the blues with you, and then after that you can let our listeners and viewers hear Ben play some tunes on his own too.
Well, this is a little tune, you know, that was taken from the wonderful work of the late great Bessie Smith, and it's always been a favorite of mine. And matter of fact, it's been very good to me.
What's the name of this
tune? Ain't Nobody's Business.
Did you first hear this on a record?
Yes, I did. Yes, I did, believe me.
Thank you. We're going to hear Jimmy Witherspoon sing Ain't Nobody's Business, accompanied by Ben Webster and Vince Guaraldi Trio, as an example of the blues songs that Ben and Spoon and the other people in jazz have kept alive through the years.
If me and my baby fuss and fight, and the next minute we all right, ain't nobody's business if we do. Thank you. nobody's business what I do. But I'm 3 times 7. That makes 21. Ain't nobody's business what I do. Ain't nobody's business what I do. Now the great Ben Webster playing Cottontail and Chelsea Bridge. Thank you. Outskirts of town. I'm gonna move way out on the outskirts of town. 'Cause I don't want nobody always hanging around. I'm gonna tell you, baby, I'm gonna move away from here. I don't want no Iceman. Gonna buy a Frigidaire when we move. I don't want nobody always hanging around.
Listening to the blues sung by Jimmy Witherspoon and played, I might almost say preached, by Ben Webster and the Vince Guaraldi Trio. And I think we have time now for another selection by Jimmy and Ben and Vince, and this is Roll 'em.
Watch all night long. Watch, 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 watch all night long. Watch, watch, watch on the doggone telephone. So bye, bye.